Hey guys, it is Halloween. Happy Halloween. A year ago today, I lost my grandma. And Amanda has a very important meeting, or a court date, I should say, today. I'm a wreck. I'm nervous. I'm scared. I'm nervous. I'm a wreck. But, yeah. Hi guys, it's been a little bit. I've been home for what? How long now?
Not very.
It's 1:10 in the afternoon. The parade and trunk or treating is at 4. My appointment, I should be able to get out in time. If not, we'll miss like 5 minutes of the parade. But we do plan on doing that. We're cleaning up the basement real quick since we have a little bit of time. I do, however, have to go get my glucose drink from upstairs around 2:30 to drink it in time, and then go get my blood drawn at 3:30 to then go to the clinic side to get my shot, which will be at 3:45. I was gonna postpone it again, but my dad and Caleb talked me out of it. So I'm enjoying meals and drinks while I can until 2:30, because after 2:30, after I drink that drink, I cannot eat or drink anything else besides that. So I'm enjoying what I can. I have to do this appointment alone. Caleb's gonna have the girls in the car, which will be running. We do have enough gas to run trunk or treat to the parade, to trunk or treating, and to do family. My mom is gonna be with Delmar at 4, so that gives me plenty enough time, because my mom, I need to update you guys on how court went. We have gotten the best news out of this entire case today than anything. Amanda is allowed unsupervised visits and overnights if this next patch comes out negative. The judge literally was saying how proud of her she was for achieving and accomplishing those goals that she made for herself. The only issue is her significant other, which she is expecting a kid with. She's going to have to make a choice. And she said that she was going to choose Salem over Ryan any day until Ryan can admit that he's got a problem. He cannot be in the picture when Amanda has unsupervised visits and overnights. So Amanda's got to choose if she wants to kick Ryan out and make Ryan go live with his dad and Grant, or his sister that lives in town, or get a place of her own, and Ryan will be living in the apartment that they are currently residing in together, and everything like that. And if he does end up getting kicked out of that apartment or that trailer, Ryan will continue to help pay Amanda's rent there, and rent for that trailer is $9.50 per month. So that is like the best news that we have received in a very long time. With this case, it's been a very downhill slope. The judge was losing hope. Everyone was losing hope. Her family was losing hope, honestly. But my mom and I actually ended up crying in the courtroom after he said, "I will allow unsupervised visits and overnights if this next patch comes out clean." And I know for a fact it will. Amanda has been doing a very good job, and I am extremely proud of her. The only issue is the significant other. As for her baby, they're gonna have to make some co-parenting skills happen. And as of right now, they are not planning on taking away this new baby. But Ryan continue using is an issue. So after court, my mom took me to Walmart to get the girls' costumes, because I mentioned that we did not have any costumes for them, and she's like, "That's not gonna work for me." So Ziva is going to be the little mermaid, and Amrith is going to be a little skeleton, and I'm going to be a pumpkin because, you know, I'm 28 weeks today. And, like, the pumpkin face is, like, going to be, like, right around here. I got sprayed by fucking Big Balls right there. So, yeah, that's great. Now I have to change the sheet on the bed again. And then I have to make something work for sheets for Stormy and her babies. But we do plan on taking the girls out to the stores, trunk or treating, and then to family. No matter how much pain I'm in, I'm not going to make the girls go without. We did end up getting candy. We have a crap ton of candy, not only for trick-or-treaters, but for my girls as well, if it gets way too cold outside to continue taking them out. We are not, like, full-on taking them trick-or-treating, mainly because after, like, 6 o'clock, it's supposed to, like, drop to the 20s, and it's just not a good environment to have our kids around, so... And for me to be around, especially with me being pregnant and me being in the third trimester, it is not a good idea for me to be out in the cold and get sick again and everything like that. And with Caleb recovering from his sickness, it's also not a very good idea. So I love you guys, and I'll catch you guys when we get ready, or when I go get my glucose drink, because that's going to be a very interesting thing. Out of my entire pregnancy, other than labor and delivery, drinking that drink has got to be the worst thing ever. Other than that, like, the pricks from, like, the needles and everything, you get used to. But, like, labor and delivery, it never gets easier. Sometimes it does, depends on the person, but with a person who doesn't like pain, it's very hard. And the fact that I've had to go to all these appointments alone, not saying it's Caleb's fault, because he could take the girls inside, but he understands it would be just, like, very hectic with a toddler and a one-year-old, so it would just not be a very good idea. So it's not even his fault. It's not even our fault. It's just that's how it so happens to be. But Caleb and I are in a really good spot right now. We did end up having a fight last night, but we resolved it, and that's all that matters. So, yeah, I love you guys, and I'll catch you guys when I go get my glucose drink.
You needed to cast the spell written on your pal Jeremy's hunter's mark.
Hey guys, so I drank the drink. I'm not really feeling the best. Extremely shaky. My stomach's upset. We are on our way to the doctor now, so yeah. Okay guys, just left the hospital. Everything is good to go now. So yeah. Okay guys, I'm waiting for the parade to start. It's a little too cold to bring out my kids, so I'm gonna be the one chasing candy. Even though I just got my blood drawn in a shot, so yeah. I'm still having a hard time. We didn't get the chance to go through all of them. We kind of like cut the line a little bit. For that dinosaur thing, there was a line all the way down to fucking Maine. We weren't gonna wait in that. And with, like, we were only outside for what?
20 minutes.
Like, my hands are fucking cold, so like I can't tell you how their hands feel. But this is everything she's got. By she, I mean him and I. Because there's no way we're gonna allow her to eat all this candy. So, yeah. Now we're visiting family, getting family over with. And then we're gonna head home. I'm still feeling weird, but it's okay. First stop, Sarah and Henry's. Next stop is Dummer's, or Claudia and Dale's. I'm still so out of it. I'm skipping Dan and Nikki's mainly because I don't want a chance running into Cassie. Then we're just gonna head home and just trick or treat. So yeah. Halloween is like used to be fun, but and it still will be once our kids get older. But right now, like, they just, it's not the perfect weather right now, and it's, they're just way too young, so, yeah, we're gonna stop by Dale and Claudette's, and then go over to Delmer's, and then head home. So, happy Halloween. I hope you guys are staying warm, staying safe.